Trump is coming. Oh, it's like a celebrity. You know, he's the fucking leader of America, and look at this shit that he said. Like, we gotta start letting these dudes know, yo, you're wrong. We need all of Britain to come out and say, yo, Trump, you're fucking wrong. Take your ass home. It's not like he's coming to do anything. He's just coming. We gotta make these people wanna quit. There was a time in hip hop where if you was doing something wrong, we gonna let you know about it. Prophets of Rage is a perfect example. When Trump comes, every radio station in the UK should just play Prophets of Rage and Rage Against the Machine all day. When Trump shows up at the gala to meet the Prime Minister and the Queen, I need everybody in the UK with a sound system in their car to pull up, everybody turn up the music to the highest decibel so this guy can understand we don't want you doing what you done against you personally. It gets personal when you start talking the way that you're talking and doing the things that you're doing. It's up to the people to understand we have the power to make these dudes not want to be in power. What's happening now in America is just an example of our stupidity coming to manifest itself. Trump isn't the problem. The whole problem in America is the dominance of attitudes in presentation and representation of Trump. What I mean by that, in America right now, disrespect, ignorance, illiteracy, and foolishness is being celebrated if it gets you attention and money. You could be a knucklehead, you could be illiterate, you can disrespect the women, you can be hateful, you can be racist, and as long as you're getting attention and you're getting money because of that, it's being important. It used to be when something like a Trump manifests itself, we call it out, we talk about it until it goes away. But right now we're celebrating it. When I was leaving America, there was a teacher retiring after 40 years at a high school in Jersey, New Jersey. After 40 years of high school in New Jersey. Nothing but success stories with this lady. And everybody had something good about her to say. She's honest, she works with you, she never gets mad at you, and she was able to change a lot of students who are going off on the wrong path. That's who should be running the world. If she could do that in a school for 40 years, what would happen if we put her up as the president? She come in the room, she don't gotta know about politics, she gotta know what's bullshit. She'll come and look, nope, we're not doing that no more, we're not doing, get the leader of that company in my office right now. Things is gonna change. There's more people capable of making change and doing the right thing and good and having effect tomorrow than the same people in politics doing the same thing over and over. So Trump is just the representation of what's been wrong from generation to generation to generation. And the big thing with Trump is not all the knucklehead stuff that he do. It's on us because we the knuckleheads allowing it to happen.